If you've ever heard a whining or groaning noise when turning, your car might already be begging for help. I've been there, stuck with a massive repair bill because I ignored the signs. Let me share exactly what I did wrong and how you can avoid the same fate. Before we move on, I'd like to ask you a small favor. If you appreciate this content, please take a second to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Over 98% of you watch the videos without subscribing. It costs you nothing, but it makes a huge difference to us. So, did you click the subscribe button? Great, thank you so much. Now back to the video. What if every time you turn your steering wheel all the way to one side, you're unknowingly shaving years off your power steering system's life? It doesn't seem like much, just holding the wheel in place for a few seconds while parking or making a tight turn. But that habit could be setting your car up for some serious problems. Let's break down exactly what's going on when you do this and why your vehicle isn't built to handle it. First, when you crank the wheel as far as it will go, whether left or right, you're putting the system into what's called full lock. This is when the steering rack, powered by the hydraulic or electric pump, has reached its maximum range of motion. Now, most modern power steering systems will make a groaning or whining noise to let you know you're at that limit. Ever notice that sound? That's the system straining under increased pressure. It's like your car's equivalent of lifting a weight it wasn't designed to handle. But instead of adjusting, many drivers keep turning or hold the wheel in that position, thinking it's harmless. Here's the kicker, it's not. At full lock, the pressure inside the hydraulic power steering system spikes. Hydraulic fluid, pumped around by the power steering pump, is there to assist you in steering smoothly. But when the wheel is held all the way over, the pump is forced to work overtime to keep pushing fluid through the system. In the short term, this creates stress on several critical components. For starters, the fluid itself heats up due to the increased pressure. While that might not sound like a big deal, it causes microscopic wear and tear on seals, hoses, and O-rings. These parts are meant to handle regular operating pressure, not the prolonged, elevated stress of full lock. Over time, this stress starts to add up. Think of the seals in your system. They're designed to keep everything contained, but as the pressure builds repeatedly, they can begin to weaken. This might start as tiny micro tears, barely noticeable at first. But as those leaks form, hydraulic fluid begins escaping. If you've ever noticed oily spots under your car or found yourself topping off the fluid more often than usual, it's a sign that these seals may already be compromised. And it doesn't stop there. The power steering pump itself takes significant abuse when it's forced to create constant high-pressure output. Pumps aren't made to deal with an extreme load for long periods. The more stress you put on it by holding the wheel at full lock, the more it wears down. Eventually, you could end up with a pump failure. When that happens, full power steering assist vanishes, making your steering heavier and harder to control, especially at low speeds. Depending on your car, replacing a power steering pump could set you back anywhere from a couple hundred to over $1,000. And that's not even considering labor costs. Now let's talk about the long-term effects on the rest of the system. Once leaks start forming, air can enter the system. Air pockets cause erratic steering, vibrations, and even more stress on the components as the pump struggles to maintain consistent pressure. Hoses that carry the fluid can bulge or burst under the added strain, and internal valves within the rack and pinion mechanism can fail. What begins as a harmless habit ends up being the root cause of an expensive series of failures. Here's the thing. Power steering systems are incredibly helpful, but they're not indestructible. They're engineered to assist you during regular driving conditions, not to endure prolonged extreme loads. Holding the steering at full lock is like asking the system to hit its red line over and over. Hydraulic engineers have explained that while these systems are durable for normal operations, they aren't built to sustain maximum pressure repeatedly. That extra strain isn't doing you or your car any favors. So that's where the chain reaction begins. A couple of seconds of full lock doesn't seem like much initially, but repeated over months or years, it wears out the system from the inside. A damaged pump might be the first noticeable failure, but it's rarely the last. Leaks, stiff steering, groaning noises. They're all symptoms of an issue that could have been avoided with a simple adjustment to your driving habits. Letting go of the wheel as soon as you hear a groan or adjusting to avoid full lock altogether can dramatically extend the life of your power steering components. But here's the important stuff. This bad habit isn't just about wearing out parts. It can compromise your safety. A sudden loss of power steering while driving could make your car difficult to control, especially at low speeds or in tight spaces. That's why understanding the impact of something so routine, like how you turn the wheel, matters more than you might think. But that's just one piece of the puzzle. Let's look at how other hidden issues silently sabotage your power steering. Your power steering fluid might be hiding a costly secret, one that's quietly eating away at the very components keeping your steering smooth. Most drivers never think twice about what's going on inside the power steering system until something feels off. Unfortunately, by the time you notice a problem, the damage is often done, and what started as a simple fluid issue can spiral into major repairs. Here's what happens. The power steering system relies entirely on clean, properly maintained fluid to function smoothly. But when that fluid gets dirty or runs low, the entire balance of the system is thrown off. Every time you turn the wheel, that fluid is pumped under high pressure to help move the steering rack. But if dirt, debris, or even microscopic metal shavings have contaminated the fluid, it acts less like a lubricant and more like an abrasive. Picture sandpaper grinding down gears and seals. It's not visible at first, but over time, the damage builds up. That increased friction within the system doesn't just wear out individual components. It also makes the pump and hoses work harder. It's a slow, silent problem that can lead to total system failure. Even worse, dirty fluid can clog the system. The small channels and valves that direct fluid where it needs to go aren't designed to handle too much contamination. A buildup of debris can narrow these pathways, forcing the power steering pump to exert more pressure just to maintain function. Over time, this extra strain causes components like hoses and pumps to weaken and, in some cases, fail altogether. If you've ever felt like your steering is heavier than usual or heard a distinctive whining noise when turning, it's often a sign that your fluid may not be circulating properly. But it's not just contamination you need to worry about. Fluid levels matter just as much. Power steering systems rely on a precise amount of fluid to operate efficiently. Too much fluid can add unnecessary strain on seals and valves, while too little fluid essentially starves the system. When the fluid level gets too low, usually because of a leak, the pump begins sucking in air. This creates air pockets that disrupt the hydraulic pressure, leading to inconsistent steering performance and additional wear on the pump. A lack of fluid also removes any lubrication, essentially leaving metal components grinding against each other. Leaks are the main cause of low fluid levels, and they don't always show obvious signs right away. A slow drip from a seal or a pinhole in a hose might go unnoticed for weeks, but during that time, the system continues to lose small amounts of fluid. Without regular checks, it's easy for these leaks to develop into larger issues. If you wait until your steering becomes stiff or noisy to investigate, it's often too late to prevent significant damage. And the cost difference is no small matter. Catching a leak early might only require replacing a single hose or seal, whereas letting it go too long could result in the need for a full pump, rack, or even entire system replacement. Your power steering system might seem tough, but it's surprisingly fragile. Addressing issues early, like dirty fluid or small leaks, can make all the difference. According to experts, leaks are a primary cause of power steering problems, leading to cascading failures, including pump damage. Ignoring these signs could result in hefty repair bills, as replacing a pump and labor costs can add up fast. Check your fluid regularly, listen for groaning noises, and adjust your driving habits to reduce unnecessary strain. And remember, every unusual sound is a warning. Your car might be telling you something that saves you in the long run.